Acne can roughly be subdivided in three different categories: mild, moderate, and severe, also named sometimes cystic. In order to better understand the different types of acne, it is important to understand and know the different features on the skin. There are about 5 different expressions that the skin can use to show you that it has acne or is undergoing acne. The first and second are open and closed comedos. They're better known as whiteheads and blackheads, respectively. These whiteheads and blackheads form when the oil glands have a small clog on their outlet duct, but there's not enough pressure for this oil to move out. The next expression on the skin is a papule. It can be several millimeters in diameter, and it is sometimes painful, sometimes not at all painful, maybe sometimes itchy. The next one is a pustule. A pustule is a red bump with a center that is white, so we call it a zit most often. The pustule is an accumulation of white blood cells in the center of that inflamed red bump. And the last expression on the skin is a cyst. The cyst sits typically underneath the skin. It is usually tender and it does not have any open connection to the skin. So in other words, the oil gland has enlarged. And it's not only the duct anymore that has enlarged, but the full gland has enlarged that sits further down inside the skin and is unable to let the oil drain and becomes inflamed underneath the skin. Many cysts have redness on top of them. There are some of the cysts that don't develop any redness on top of them. In acne, we see a variation of these different expressions on the skin. In mild acne, there are most often blackheads and whiteheads. Very occasionally, some of those red bumps, the inflammatory papules. In moderate acne, we see predominantly these inflammatory papules, some pustules, some blackheads and whiteheads, but the pustules and papules are not very large and they're not usually very tender. In severe or cystic acne, the cysts predominate, larger papules and pustules predominate, and there are oftentimes also blackheads and whiteheads, but they are not the majority of the skin expressions. Many people also have other expressions on the skin that don't actually belong to the feature of acne by itself, but are an after state. And these are darkened areas, we call them areas of post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation or post-inflammatory erythema. These are areas where acne expressions have gone away, but have not fully resolved yet. And they can also be present in a number of people who have acne. Not all acne lesions go away as soon as they erupt, but they can oftentimes stay for a little while. And it is possible to have a mixed picture on the skin. In the next segment, I will speak about the various treatments for the different types of acne.